Now here we take another case of refraction. Now the curved surface is a concave surface. This is the denser part and this part is the rarer part. In the denser part, this middle point is pressed inside. This is the pole and the sides are up and the middle point is pressed. This is a concave surface. So, it is a refraction through concave surface. The object is placed here in the rarer medium and the rays are traveling towards concave medium and we are observing it from this side. We are observing it from this side. Okay. Now, here from the object we have to take the two rays. One we take as always along the principal axis, that will go undeviated. So here we have it this way. The one ray will go along the principal axis and that will go undeviated this way. The other, any ray which is going towards a point Q on the surface, when it strikes at point Q, to find out its whereabout, we draw a normal here. The normal is always a line joining this point to the center of curvature. This is center of curvature. So, this is normal up to N. Now, this is incident ray. After going to the denser medium, what will happen to the incident ray? Answer, it will bend towards normal. So, this is the direction original and this will bend toward normal. This has bent toward normal. Now, this one ray is entering our eye and this is the other ray entering our eye, this one. So, where do we see the image? To the common point. Now, this direction and this direction, they do not intersect. Actually, so they do not form a real image. But if both are drawn backward, this appears to come from this point and this also appears to come from this point. So this is a common point and what we perceive in our eyes that both these rays are coming from this point, so the object is lying at this point. So, object we perceive to be lying at this point, so this is called image. We see the object here. So, this is image. This is how we decided how the formation will be. See what we have followed? Rarer to denser, it will always bend toward normal. This bend toward normal. Okay. Now, this has happened. So, we see the image here. Now, where are the distances? Answer, this distance object to the pole is u. Image to the pole is v. And center of curvature to the pole is radius of curvature r. These are the distances. It has refractive index mu and the curvature is 1 upon r always. Okay. Now we have to establish a relation between u, v, refractive index and curvature. How we start? The same way what we have done in the previous lecture. This is just to tell you that the formula will not change. There may be different cases of object placed here, there, anywhere. And what was the formula we did in the earlier case? Remember, that was mu upon v minus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon r mu minus 1. Okay, that was for which case? That was for convex. And what type of image? Real image. Now what we are taking? Concave. And what type of image? Virtual image. there may be variety different types. Now here we start again, and this time we will do it a bit fast. This is angle of incidence I and this is angle R. So our starting point will be same. Sin I upon sin R is equal to mu. Sin I upon sin R is equal to mu. Or we can write it, I is equal to mu into R. Okay. Then I, this is I, where is alpha, beta, gamma? The angle with object we made as alpha. The angle of incident ray we make as alpha. Angle with refracted ray we made as beta, and the one with the radius of curvature we made as gamma. Same notation we are using in all the derivations. Okay, now I is equal to what? Here, make out anything. I, in which triangle? Can you make it? Yes, that's right. Here is alpha is equal to gamma plus I in this triangle. Q, C, O, Q. C, O, Q. Alpha is equal to gamma plus I. So I is equal to alpha minus gamma. Alpha minus gamma is equal to mu into R. What is R here? Here is R, this. And this R is equal to opposite angle, this. This is R. Now, this R, how can we relate it to alpha, beta and gamma? See beta. Beta in the triangle C, I, Q. C, I, Q, C. Beta is external angle, it is equal to gamma plus R. Therefore, R is equal to beta minus gamma. So, R is equal to beta minus gamma. So, this will be now the next step, alpha minus this gamma we will put on this side, and this will be only alpha. Minus gamma will come here. Here mu into gamma minus, that will become plus mu into gamma. This minus mu into gamma going on this side will become plus mu into gamma equal. No. We will place gamma on one side. Here mu into beta, which is plus, will become minus mu into beta is equal to, this gamma will go there, will become positive, and this will be minus mu into gamma, mu into gamma. Okay, then alpha minus mu beta converting to tangent. What? Alpha can be converted approximately equal to tan alpha. So this will be tangent alpha minus mu tangent beta is equal to gamma, and this will be 1 minus mu, and this gamma we can write as tangent gamma. Now value of tangent alpha, here is alpha, the value is qm upon om. Everywhere we are taking the value as perpendicular upon base. And we choose such triangles that perpendicular for all the values will become same, so that we can cancel out in the later stage. So here tangent alpha will be qm upon om. Qm upon om minus mu into tangent beta. Tangent beta is qm upon im. Qm upon im is equal to tangent gamma. gamma here tangent QM upon CM, QM upon CM, this is 1 minus mu. Okay, now QM, divide all the terms with QM, cancel, cancel, cancel. And now we get it, 1 upon OM minus mu upon IM is equal to 1 upon CM into 1 minus mu. Okay, now put the values. One upon OM. OM is U and the sign is negative. So, this is 1 upon minus U. This is mu upon IM. IM. This is the distance V, but it is also on the left side. So, this will be negative. So, mu upon minus V, and this minus is there, minus mu IM is equal to minus V, and this is equal to 1 upon CM. CM, CM is radius of curvature and this is on the left side, so we will write it minus R, and this is 1 minus mu. Okay, now this minus and minus will become plus. So, this plus we will place first. So, this will become mu upon V and this is minus 1 upon U. Minus 1 upon U is equal to this minus, please multiply it with this. This will become mu minus 1 and this will become positive. So, 1 upon R and this is mu minus 1. This is the result we get and please compare it with the previous result. Mu upon V, 1 upon U, 1 upon R, mu minus 1, no change. So, here it was convex and the image was real. In this case, the surface is concave and the image is virtual. Both the things have changed, but there is no change in formula. And we can make many more things, like this is a concave one, that was convex one. In case of convex, if the image is virtual, again you will get the same thing. Automatically, alpha, beta, gamma, minus u, minus v, they will take their sign in such a way that your final result will always land up like this. Yes, there will be one change. In all these cases, the object is lying in a rarer medium. In case we put the object in denser medium, then what will happen? The answer is, if this is in the denser medium, then U, which is in the rarer medium, that U have gone to the denser medium.